Assalamu alaikum. Very good afternoon, dear students. So as we completed the first part of the explanation of this chapter, that is Tiger Hills. So now here is the part 2 of the explanation. So we'll start here. Northern spur and obtained a toehold just 30 meters from the top. Now it was about the, like, you know, that the way they were conquering the parts and they were, you know, getting their hold. So it was all about that. At 400 hours on the 4th July, after a carefully orchestrated artillery combatment, Sachin Imbalkar and Balwant Singh along with their men approached Tiger Hill top by climbing a sheer cliff and caught the enemy unawares. Now, on the 400th hour, that was on 4th of July. So, what they did, Sachin Imbalkar and Balwant Singh, along with their men, the other people were also there with them, the other men were also there. They approached the Tiger Hill top, okay, by climbing a sheer cliff and caught the enemy unawares. And when they climbed towards the top, the enemies were completely unaware. They didn't know that, you know, someone is going to attack or like they have to be prepared for the fight or anything else. They were not at all aware of anything like that, you know, any of the assault is going to happen. So they were completely surprised. After a spell of hand-to-hand fighting, they succeeded in capturing the objective. Now, you know, there were hand-to-hand fighting. Okay, and after doing that, they successfully got the capture over there. Although 18 grenadiers held the top now, linking up with them was not easy. When the initial surprise wore off, the enemy started gearing up for launching counter attacks. So now what he's saying, the 18 grenadiers, now they are holding the top. And you know, linking up with them obviously was not that easy. And now what he's saying over here, that, you know, when the initially when they attacked on the enemies, so obviously they were not aware of it, but slowly as they came to know that someone attacked, and like, you know, they started gearing up for the counter attacks, or to basically we can say to fight back with them. One of the most difficult tasks during the course of a battle is to maintain one's hold on the ground captured before the next assault can be launched. Now, what became their, you know, their focus or the priority is to continue the hold or to maintain that hold what they have done. If they captured one place, they should have their hold over there. It should not happen like, you know, they captured one place, now they are going to hold the another, or to capture the another part, so they are leaving it just like that and they comes back and they hold it back. So it should not happen like that, right? So they had to make it sure that they had to, like, you know, maintain their hold, their capture over there, what they already done. So in search of other capture or like something like that, they cannot lose the hold of a first place, right? So that's what they had to make sure, that they should not lose the hold on a previous part what they have already captured before the next assault can be launched. Throughout the next morning, artillery drills continued. Casualties mounted on both sides. The grenadiers hung on to their precarious perch. With grit and determination, Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav and his team members exhibited exceptional courage during this assault. Now what he's saying, you know, after the throughout the morning, till the morning, the artillery duels continued. Duel is basically fight, okay? So now the fight which was happening with artilleries, so the casualties means the people who were injured or who were dead, so the number of casualties were increasing both the sides. And the grenadiers, they hung onto their precarious perch. Precarious is basically the place which is not safe or kind of dangerous. And perch is what? Basically a high position. So the grenadiers who were there, who were they stuck towards the precarious perch only. And so that, you know, with full determination, so that they should not lose their hold from there. And Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav and his team member exhibited exceptional courage during this assault. So basically the person called Yogendra Singh, who was there, Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav and his team members, they exhibited exceptional courage during the whole assault. At this stage, 8th Mount Division realized that it would not be possible to evict the enemy from Tiger Hill completely as long as his supply lines along the western spur were intact. Mohinder Puri and MPS Bajwa then issued orders to 8th Sikh to attack and capture Helmand and India Gate. So basically what they came to know at this stage that the 8th Mountain Division, they realized that, you know, it will not be possible to have the complete hold or to capture the whole Tiger Hill if we do not, you know, stop the supply of the enemies. So it will not be possible to get the complete capture. So Mohinder Puri and MPS Bajwa, what they issued the orders to 8 Sikh to attack and capture the Helmand. So they ordered those 8 Sikhs to attack from the on the Helmand and India Gate, both located on the western spur. So where it was located? On the western spur, so that enemy reinforcement to Tiger Hill top could be prevented. Like, you know, if the number of enemies, if it is getting decreased, if they are dying, and now if they are getting more people to fight from the other sources, so obviously it will become difficult for us to fight and to, you know, to get the capture or to get the hold over there. So that's what they realized. We have to stop the reinforcement of the enemies so that we can capture the Tiger Hill. The move was also intended to cut off the enemy supply route. The western spur of the Tiger Hill extended up to 1.5 kilometers. The approach to the spur, where 8 Sikh was deployed, lay along a steep rock face, and an ad hoc column of 8 Sikh led by Major Ravindra Singh and Lieutenant R.K. Sehrawat, comprising from JCOs and 52 soldiers, climbed this rock face under poor visibility conditions and was able to capture India Gate after a tough fight. Now, the western spur of a Tiger Hill, it was extended up to 1.5 km. And now they were approaching towards the spur, okay, where already 8 Sikh have been, already assigned with the task, and there was steep rock face, and then the ad hoc column were there. Now there were Major Ravindra Singh, Lieutenant R.K. Sehrawat, they were there, and even the 8 Sikhs who was there, and 4 JCOs were also there, and at the same time 52 soldiers, and they climbed to under complete poor visibility condition. As we know, it was night and everything was dark, nothing was visible. So they climbed in that poor visibility condition and they captured the India Gate. They had tough fight before capturing, and after having a tough fight, they finally captured the India Gate. And then in this battle, Subedar Nirmal Singh led the assault platoon. And who led the assault over here? There was Subedar Nirmal Singh. And then he was engaged in hand-to-hand fighting till the end, and was also responsible for beating back a counter-attack. And Subedar Nirmal Singh, basically, he was engaged in hand-to-hand fighting. Okay, and till the end, he was there, responsible for it. And he was also giving the counter-attack, means fighting back. Despite heavy casualties, 8 Sikh exploited its success up to Helmand and captured this objective on 5 July. So, you know, there were heavy casualties, and then even after that, the 8 Sikh who have been assigned with the task, so they exploited its success up to the Helmand, and they finally captured the objective on 5th July. The enemy launched 2 counterattacks with 40 to 50 personnel, but 8 Sikh fought gallantly and was able to repulse them. So the enemy, they launched 2 counterattacks. Okay, and over there were 40 to 50 personnel were there, people were there to fight. But these 8 Sikh, they fought just amazingly, and due to that, they were able to repulse them. Naib Subedar Karnail Singh and Rifleman Satpal Singh, who were part of a platoon deployed on the reverse slope of Helmand, showed exceptional courage. Now there was another person it's talking about, Naib Subedar Karnail Singh and Rifleman Satpal Singh. They were, they showed exceptional courage, and they deployed the reverse slope of Helmand. In one of these counterattacks, Captain Colonel Sher Khan of the Pakistan Army was killed. His body was subsequently handed over to the Pakistani authorities. Now, while doing the counterattacks and everything, so the captain of the Pakistan army, that was Colonel Sher Khan, he was killed by the Indian army. And his body was handed over to the Pakistani authority. And then other bodies of the Pakistani soldiers found scattered around the battleground were collected and buried appropriately. So the other casualties who were there, the other dead bodies which was there of Pakistanis, so what Indian soldiers did, they which was scattered, they collected all the bodies and they buried it appropriately the way it was supposed to be done. In New Delhi, I had remained anxious all through the night of 3 July. The next morning, Krishan Pal, GOC, 15 Corps, rang up at 600 hours to inform me that 18 grenadiers had captured Tiger Hill Top and also that heavy fighting was going on. So, as the writer about whom we discussed in the very beginning only, so he had been very anxious throughout the time. And he has been waiting for the, you know, the update that what's happening and what, like, you know, what exactly the state over there. So finally, he got a call from the GOC, Krishan Pal, at 300 hour, and that was on 3rd July. And what he informed that 18 grenadiers had captured the Tiger Hill Top. And still the heavy fighting is going on. After consulting him and Nirmal Chanderwij, we decided to wait confirmation from the GOC 8 Mountain Division. And they already got the call from them, but still they waited for the confirmation from the GOC 8 Mountain Division. At 7:30 hours, Mohinder Puri confirmed to me that the enemy would not be able to dislodge 18 grenadiers from Tiger Hill Top. Now, finally, at 7:30 hour, I got a call from Mohinder Puri, and what he informed me that now it is going to be impossible to dislodge 18 grenadiers from the Tiger Hill Top. Means now we have our capture over there. I duly informed Brajesh Mishra and the Prime Minister, who was scheduled to address a public meeting in Haryana at 1000 hours. The Defense Minister was on his way to Amritsar. When he landed at the airport, I gave him this exciting news. So now, as he came to know, he informed Brajesh Mishra and also he informed the Prime Minister. And Prime Minister was, there was a schedule of him to address a public meeting which was in Haryana. And he also informed the Defense Minister, okay, who was on his way to Amritsar. And then he landed at the airport. I gave him this exciting news. So when he landed on the airport, then he gave this exciting news to him. The date for July 1999 was important for one more reason. Nawaz Sharif was due to meet the US President Bill Clinton later in the day. About 10 to 15 hours before their meeting, we made sure that the whole world come to know about the recapture of Tiger Hill and thus the likely outcome of the war. So basically what he is saying that the date for July 1999, it was also important for one more reason. That was, Nawaz Sharif was about to meet the US president, and who was the president that time? Bill Clinton. So that day, on that day only, later he was about to meet him. So what they made sure, the Indians, everyone, that before their meeting, the whole world should come to know about our recapture of the Tiger Hill, so that it should be asked at the time of meeting and it should be discussed over there. They should also come to know about it. And then for some time Pakistan even denied the existence of such mountain feature and labeled the entire operation as a figment of our imagination. The loss of Tiger Hill was a hard physical and psychological blow. In India, wave of jubilation and relief replaced the gloomy mood of the people. Now, in the beginning, when the whole instance took place, the whole thing happened, the Pakistanis, they denied from the existence of such place. They denied that there was no existence of such place, Tiger Hill Top or something like that. And they labeled it like, you know, it is all your imaginative stories and everything. That's how they labeled us. And they got a hard blow, a physically also and psychologically also. They got a blow, a hard blow from Indians. And obviously in India there was a wave of happiness. Everyone was so happy before getting a capture over there, before getting a hold over there. Everyone was in a gloomy mood, right? Everyone was a bit sad and like worried what will happen next. But now the victory and the hold over there got replaced by the jubilation of relief. On 8 July, after the entire Tiger Hill objective had been cleared and the situation stabilized, 18 grenadiers hoisted the Indian tricolor on Tiger Hill top. So finally, on 8th July, after the whole and the entire Tiger Hill objective had been done, so when the situation got stable, so now the 18 grenadiers, they hoisted the Indian tricolor on the Tiger Hill top. Throughout this tenure, in the nearly 2 month long war, the battalion acquitted itself with high professionalism and honor, displaying unshakable determination and collective valor. All its members covered themselves with glory and notched up two of the finest victories for the Indian Army. After the war, as the battalion requested a UN mission, Army headquarters sent it to Sierra Leone, West Africa. There too, the battalion successfully carried out a major rescue operation, Operation Kukri. Now, as 18 grenadiers and everyone, they took the mission successfully. They carried out the mission successfully. So then they went to the Sierra Leone, which was in West Africa. They went to carry out the mission or the Operation Kukri. So they took out, they carry forward the mission successfully over there also. So I hope you must have understood. Now the activity part, that is the brainstorming part, we'll do in the upcoming lecture. Thank you very much.